Hi guys, welcome to WebSense Pro, welcome to another video. This is a channel where you learn about WordPress, web designing, web development, Shopify and lot of other stuff online. So in this video, I'm gonna show you guys how you can optimize your WordPress database. So if you have ever noticed, if you are a WordPress developer or you have a WordPress website or you're the owner of the WordPress website, you might have noticed that by the time the backend of your WordPress website gets very slow. And it's because of the reason that you add a lot of different plugins, and by the time the database gets very heavy. And in this video, I'm going to show you guys how you can optimize your WordPress website database. So I'm on our company website and I'm going to show you the cPanel. Here's the cPanel. And we will navigate to our database and running some queries to optimize our database. And I'm going to show you guys how it affects the database and how it reduces the size of our database. Before we go any further, guys, we have recently created a Shopify app, and it's a cool app. So that's the link of the Shopify app. You will find the link in the description. So if you want to increase sales of your Shopify store, make sure to use that app. And this app going to add a feature on your store where you can create tire discount. So let me open up that screenshot, and here you can see we have if someone add in 2 items from the cart, it's going to add 10%, and if someone add 3 item, it's going to add 20%. You can add another tier, so it's a tier based discount, so you can basically incentivize your user to add more item to the cart for getting more discount. It's a really great way to increase the average order value and increase the overall sales. So make sure to check that out. Link in the description. Okay, now let's proceed with our tutorial. We will be working on our company website, and this is the website, and this is the cPanel of the website. Now let's navigate to phpMyAdmin, and we have lots of different websites, and that's the database of this website. So if I click on this database and check out the WP underscore options table, so that's our WPTH underscore options table. Here I can see the website URL, right? Now let's click on this database. And if we take a look at the comment meta, so that's the table which says comment meta, you can see it's 6.6 MB and it's 4.6 MB, which is our comments table. It shouldn't be that heavy because we just have like few thousand comments on our website. And if I scroll down further, and try to find out the heaviest tables in our database, you can see the post meta table is also 30 MB, which is really huge, and it shouldn't be that huge. And our total database size, if I scroll down to the bottom, you can see the total database size is 82 MB, and it shouldn't be that heavy because we have like few hundred pages and few thousand comments on the website. So it doesn't make sense to have 82 MB worth of MySQL entries, right? Which makes like millions of database entries. So what we're gonna do, we will optimize this database, and I'm gonna show you guys how you can do that. But before making any action, make sure to export and download the backup of the database, because if something bad happens, your website is gonna go down and you will not be able to retrieve it back again. So make sure to have a backup of your database. How you can create a database: simply click on your database and then click on export, and then from export click on export again, and now it's downloading the database. Okay guys, our database has been downloaded, right? Now let's start optimizing our database and how we can do that. So these are the queries, and I'm going to provide these queries in the description. So you will find a blog post link in the YouTube video description where you can simply find all of these queries. You don't have to manually type that all. Okay, and now first we were going to run this first query. What it will do is it will basically find the comments, find the metadata for the comments that do not have any comment. So WordPress creates a metadata where comment is created, and when we delete the comment, it just additionally create the data which is called metadata, and we're gonna find that and delete that if there is any extra metadata in our WordPress database. So So I'm just going to copy this query and click on SQL from our database and then paste this query. And now you will notice in this query that we have this your prefix. So every WordPress database have a different prefix. You might have a default WordPress database table prefix, which is WP underscore. In my case, the database table prefix is WPTH underscore, right? So I'm going to replace your underscore prefix underscore with WPTH underscore, which is my database table prefix. Similarly, I'm going to do the same here. So wherever you see your underscore prefix underscore, make sure to replace that with your own database table prefix. Cool, I have done that. And then I'm gonna hit on this go button here. And now you can see that we do not have any additional comment meta, which we can delete. So it just returned the empty result set. So we are not gonna delete that data. If it results with some data, you will have to run this second query, which is going to delete all the metadata which do not have comment anymore. So it will reduce some space from your table and it will optimize your database. Okay, now let's move on to the second query. So this is the query which will find the comments that have been incorrectly flagged as spam by Akismet. So Akismet is a free plugin which prevents spam comments, and when it does, it creates an additional data to your database. Now we're gonna find that if we have that in our database. So I'm just going to copy this query and then paste this query by clicking on this SQL. And again, I'm going to replace your underscore prefix underscore with my table prefix. And now I'm going to click on this go button. And here you can see that we have 9,428 columns of data, rows of data, which we can simply delete, right? Now we're gonna apply the second query to delete all of that data. So I'm just going to copy this query here. So this query will delete all metadata for comments that have been flagged incorrectly as spam by Akismet. So let's copy that. And then click on SQL again and then paste it and then add in my table prefix and then I'm going to click on go. Guys, before adding any delete query to your MySQL table, always make sure to have a backup of that specific table and the database in whole. So first, what I'm going to do, I'm going to simply export this table. So I'm under WP underscore comment meta table. So I'm just going to click on that and then click on export and then click on export. Okay, we have this table saved. And before adding the delete query, let's also analyze how much optimization we are gonna making, right? So click on the database. And this is our comment meta table where the size of the table is 6.6 MB, right? Now let's run the query and see how much we're gonna save from the 6.6 MB. Okay, now let's click on query again and then click on SQL and then paste the query. And now I'm going to replace this with WPTH underscore. Perfect. Now let's click on go. It's giving me a warning that you will delete this data. I'm fine with that. Click on OK. Okay, now you can see we have 9,428 rows deleted. Now let's click on the database and see how much we optimized the table. Okay, now if I check the size of comment meta table, you can see it's just now 4.0 KB. Previously, it was 6 MB, something around 6 MB. So it's a really good practice to optimize your database, right? Now we're going to move on to the next step. Okay, so we did these four queries. Now we will optimize our post meta table. So if I go to my database again and check out the post meta table, that's where you will find most of the clutter, and it's going to be the most heaviest table of your database. So let's search for post meta. So here it is. So if I check out the size of this table, you can see it's, oops, I'll find that again. Yep. Okay, so it's 30.4 MB. So out of our 80 MB database, it's taking around 40 to 45% of the size, right? And we're gonna optimize that. So let's do that. Click on this SQL and then copy this query here. So what it's gonna do, it's going to find the rows which basically have null values and created by different plugins, and these rows does not have any use anymore, right? So I'm just going to copy this query, paste this query here, and then replace this with my database table prefix. Perfect. And now let's click on go. And here you can see we have more than 6,000 queries with the null ID, right? Which is basically the redundant data. So what we're going to do, we will first again download this table before adding the delete query. So click on export and then click on export again. Okay, our post meta table has been downloaded. Now let's click on SQL and add in the delete query. So that's the query. So repeating that again, that all of these queries will be in the blog post of this YouTube video description. Okay, so just paste the query, replace this with the database table prefix. And I'm gonna run this query. Okay, our additional rows has been deleted. Now let's go back to the database and see how much size we reduced. Okay, it's still showing 30.4 MB. Now, if you're having this issues and after adding this query, you're not seeing any difference in the size of the table, what you can do here is just click on the table. Sorry about that. So I'm going to click on this table here, this check mark, scroll down all the way to the bottom. And then from this drop down here, scroll down and click on optimize table. Once you do that, go back to the table. Let's search it again. And now you can see it's now 12.6 MB from 30.5 MB. So when we started the database table optimization, we were around 80 MB in our database, and now we have reduced down to 57.1 MB. So we have reduced like 20 to 30% of our database extra load, and it is going to speed up our website backend and also the front end. So it's really important for you guys to run these queries and check again, have a backup before adding the delete query, and it's going to speed up your website backend and the front end. And that's it for the video, guys. If you want to watch more videos to optimize your WordPress website, let me know in the comments below and I'll create more videos for you guys. And make sure to subscribe our channel, which will help us create more valuable content for you guys. Until next video, have a great day.